Hey guys, what's up? It's Court. Welcome back to my channel. Or if you're new here, hi, my name is Court. I do bookish and outdoor lifestyle content here on my channel. So if that sounds like your jam, if that sounds like your thing, make sure to thumbs up, subscribe, and stick around. Today we have a video that has been highly, highly anticipated, and I'm so thrilled to share it with you guys. Today we're going to be building a bookshelf, sticking it in my room, and showing you guys. I am partnering with Nathan James on today's video, and they were so kind to send me the Theo bookshelf. I can't wait. Hopefully I'm able to build this by myself. If not, my back has not been giving me the best lately, so we may have to recruit Rita's to help us. But I think it should be easy. I think it's pretty straightforward. I'll kind of show you guys the vision that I have of setting it up. I want to set it up next to our bed, next to my nightstand, and kind of have like a TBR shelf. A lot of people do TBR carts. I want a TBR shelf. I want to be able to just like finish my book in my bed and grab my next book that I want to read. That's kind of the vision. That said, let's go ahead and pull the box into the frame. It was delivered today. I want to open it up and I want to show you guys. Instructions. Look how sleek that is. Oh, I'm excited. Okay, so here are all the shelves. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 shelves I'm gonna be able to put books on. Probably a good time to read the instructions because I wonder if I need to, if I can build it and put it on the wall or if I need to put it on the wall first. It does say a 40-minute assembly, which is pretty promising. You can scan the QR code too if you want inspiration and digital setup. That's pretty advanced, pretty cool. Okay, I think I should be able to put it together and then have Rita's mount it. I think. Step one is putting together the metal. Step two is adding the shelves. Step three is putting it on the wall, and step four is like applying it to the wall. So no heartburn, we'll handle the return. That's funny. Okay, cool. All right, let's see if we can tackle this ourselves. Okay, let me take these all out of their wrappers. Remember the last time I like genuinely built something, probably in like Girl Scouts. I probably should have looked at these labels before pulling these off. I didn't think about that. I just thought that I'd be able to tell what was what. Okay, we're gonna do process of elimination of the ones that I already opened and do those last. So this is C that goes into D that also goes into B. What are you? Okay. This is gonna be a really tall shelf. Wait, this has to be the bottom because it has, and then this goes this way. I got it. Okay. All right, so this is how tall, it doesn't even fit in the frame, how tall essentially the bookshelf is gonna be. Is it bad that I'm now having second thoughts about putting it on this wall? No, I think I gotta see, because I think the shelves would hang over. I think. Yeah, I think they'd be too big. I'd be hitting myself on them when I walked in the door. Let's stick to the bedroom for these. Theoretically, I think it goes like that. This is nice.
they labeled it by what step you need the tools for.
Smart. Just for clarification, this is not going here. This is going in my bedroom, but I'm just building it here so you guys can see it. Because in the bedroom, I feel like it's gonna be harder to angle the camera until I set it up.
I think I messed up.
Because this slides in here, but my bookshelf is facing the wrong way. Unless, wait, did I do it right? No, won't fit that way. Oh, it will, it will. Did I not mess up? I am so confused. Obviously, there's supposed to be a screw that goes down here, but where does it go? Where does it go through? I'm gonna take a break and I'm gonna figure this out and then I will film again when I've got it figured out. So please hold.
Guys, it is a new day and I have officially set up, decorated, organized my bookshelf, and I'm so excited to share it with you guys. I did have a little help from my fiance. He set it up in our bedroom next to our bed, so I literally have a TBR shelf, which is so exciting. I've had my books on the floor, and I still have some books on the floor since November when we moved here, and it's just so nice to get the books off the floor, organize them, put them on display. I'm just so, so pumped. So let's stop talking and let me show you a little bookshelf tour. Okay, so like I said, I have the Theo bookshelf set up right next to our bed, and it just fits perfectly. It's so exciting to just be able to grab anything that I want to read. This is basically my own little like bookstore. I haven't read any of these books, so let's get a closer look. So on the top shelf, this is all of my Halloween, spooky, fall, autumn type books, and then also my little Zero that Regis and I got. Well, he got it for me when we started dating. And then I have these really cute little bookends that are cats that my mom gifted me. But like I said, yes, all of my Halloween books that I want to read for the upcoming year. A lot of Grady Hendrix. We've got Paperbacks from Hell, Murder Your Employer, All Hallows, Nestling by Nat Cassidy, Krampus by Brom, Vampira, My Best Friend's Exorcism, The Southern Book Club's Guide to Slaying Vampires, Horror Store, Stephen King's It, Tender as the Flesh, A Good Girl's Guide to Murder, and Gallant. And then moving on to the second shelf, this is more of my magic, fantasy, dark academia, that kind of thing. And I've honestly been getting into this world of like fantasy a lot more this year in 2024. So these are the books that I have. I've got Ninth House, Spells for Forgetting, The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue, Babel, Yellowface, Brissinger, Aragorn, Eldest, the first two Harry Potter books, Sanctuary of the Shadow, Neon Gods, The Unfortunate Side Effects of Heartbreak and Magic, first three books in the ACOTAR series. No, I haven't read them yet. The Assassin's Blade, Nightbane, which is the second book in the Lightlark series. Sorry, my cat is going crazy. Strange the Dreamer and Legendary, which I do have Finale and Carvel, but they are in the other bedroom. Moving on to the third shelf, this is my romance of types, dark romance, beach romances, small town romances, dark romances. I already said that, but you get the idea. I also have this little thing that has a bunch of different bookmarks, tabs, highlighters to reach for. But as far as books, I have My Dark Romeo, Gothicana, If He Had Been With Me, Cleopatra and Frankenstein,
Love Redesigned, a bunch of Emily Henry books, the Chestnut Spring series outside of Hopeless. I told myself I can't buy anymore until I read these. Crossed and Twisted, and this really cute little heart that Rita's got me for Valentine's Day last year. It's us. You can't really see, but it is us. Then moving on to this shelf, I guess I would call this my thriller suspense type books, which I don't have a lot. My friend Rachel reads a ton of thrillers, so I'm definitely getting into this genre as well. But I do have Otesh Ramachandran's Eileen that I started, this really cute little miniature bookshelf that my mom gifted me for Christmas, Bright Young Women, which I also started, The Maidens Falling, The Woman in Cabin 10, and In a Dark, Dark Wood. And moving on to the second to last shelf, this is kind of like a hodgepodge of random books. So I've got like holiday books, like more summery books, and then a Christmas book. So I have Malibu Rising, The Gunkle, and In a Holidays. Then I have some classics here, Phantom of the Opera, Dracula, Frankenstein, All the Good Things. This this is just a jar of like random stuff. And then I have what I call sad books. So I have My Little Life, Dark Vanessa, My Year of Rest and Relaxation, and I randomly have The Cat Who Saved Books. And then on this last shelf, this is kind of my catch-all shelf and my current shelf. So it's not as aesthetic, but I figured since it's at the bottom, it's not that big of a deal. So I have my current reads, which I'm listening to Love in the Time of Serial Killers. Not my favorite. I don't know if I'll finish it or not. My physical read is The 7-Year Slip. And then I'm also rereading 13 Things Mentally Strong Women Don't Do. I love Amy Morin's 13 Things Mentally Strong People Don't Do. So when I saw that she had a specific one for women, I decided to pick it up. And then again, I have some tabs, stickers, highlighters, and remotes. So all in all, I am absolutely obsessed with the shelf. I am so excited to just have it here again. It's like a little bookshop that I can just pull from whenever I want to read something new. I love it so much.
Alrighty, everybody, that is my bookshelf tour, my review of the Theo bookshelf, and just my overall thoughts. I love it. I'm super excited. I know this bookshelf is going to move with me from place to place as I evolve and like move throughout the years. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much to Nathan James for sending it to me and helping work on this video with me. I am just so grateful and so thankful. So, hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I'll talk to you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.